Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Praise to be Allah, wahyu permas to all of us so that we can meet at the virtual meeting today. Selawat berangkaikan salam, marilah kita kirimkan buat Nabi junjungan umat, yakninya Nabi Yuna Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Okay, today we from Group 4 will presentation. Before we presentation the material, before presentation, I'm introduce our group. First, Indri Noviardi as moderator, and Hanifa Amran, Indah Permata Afi, and Raitasha Givara. The first session will be reading material. The first material will be read by Hanifa Amran. To Hanifa, time is yours.
Okay, thanks to the moderator to opportunity. Definition of drawing with tissue. According to Olivia and Hari in Wijaya, drawing is the most expressive medium because your little one can directly express his imagination in the form of an expression of ideas from within himself. Drawing with tissue is an activity that use tissue media as drawing tool. Children can also express their creativity, imagination, and expression by drawing on tissue. Okay, next, purpose and benefits of drawing with tissue. The purpose of drawing on tissue for early childhood is as follows. One, obtain the satisfaction of children who are in the growth and development phase. Second, channeling children's emotion. Through drawing, children can express what is in their hearts without any restraints. And third, make it easier for children to express themselves. For young children, every activity carried out has benefits as well as drawing on tissue. The benefits of drawing according to Pamadi in Tirtayati 2014 are as follows. First, drawing as a storytelling tool, visual language or form. Second, drawing as a medium to express feelings. Third, drawing as a play tool. And fourth, drawing trains memory. Okay. Sekian dari saya kembalikan kepada moderator.
Thank you to Hanifah. The next material will be read by Indah Permata Afi. To Indah, time is yours.
Okay, thank you moderator. The materi next, purpose and benefits of drawing with tissue. In line with that, there are also benefits of drawing on tissue as follows. First, building parent-child bonding. Second, provide fun and positive activities for children. Third, introducing colors to children. Fourth, stimulate children's fine motor skills. Five, provide experience to children in learning colors from experiment they do themselves. Six, train children to communicate well from an early age. Seven, train children to learn to observe everything. Eight, train children to think critically and the last, increase knowledge. And the next, drawing tools and materials with tissue. Painting with these tissues can develop aspect of children's knowledge and fine motor development of children. The tools and material need are first tissue, second color makers, third color paint or watercolor or food coloring, fourth alas, and the last cotton bud. Okay, thank you. I'll turn back to the moderator.
Thanks to Inda, the last material will be read by Rita Shagifara. To Rita Shagifara, from Asia.
Okay, thank you to moderator. The next material is step to draw with a tissue. The first is introduce the name of tools and material to be used in children. Second, introduce children to the color to be used. Third, let the child paint freely with the watercolor color tissues while we recognize the name of each color. And the last, don't forget to include praise and positive word for children so that children are enthusiastic and their activity become more fun for children. Okay, the next is practice drawing with tissue. The first is condition the children before the activity start to the so that the class atmosphere become more orderly. Second, introducing children to batik media, namely tissue and markers. Third, explain to child about the function media of the tissue. Four, the teacher explain what activity will be carried out to student, namely activity batik. Previously, the teacher demonstrate how to make batik by showing how to fold the tissue and how to hold the marker correctly. The teacher direct show to make batik, then show the finished image. Next, ask the child to slowly fold the tissue into a square shape in a way tissue folded to fold. Six, introduce the child to hold the marker correctly and pick up the color of the marker what the child want. Seven, instruct the child how to hold the marker when making batik, do thing this with the correct finger position. Eight, modify that are freely format can be the form of lines, circle, or according to the child activity. And the last is, after the tissue fold are open, a beautiful batik pattern has format on the tissue. Okay, I turn back to the moderator. Thank you.
Okay, thank you to Rita Shagifara. And that's all material from group 4. Thank you for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.